everybody, and welcome to another video review. Today we'll be taking a look at the Corraldi Smart Kit, which was sent to me for review purposes. No money has exchanged hands, so this will represent my personal opinion on the device, and we followed up with a detailed video discussing what the company could do to improve the follow-up version of this product. I personally like to see companies improve, so I hope they will take the information I present in these two videos to create something that pushes innovation. I will be posting a link in the description below as to where you can actually purchase this device. However, I strongly recommend that you watch until the end of the video before you even click on the link. So what is this set of devices supposed to do exactly? Well, the intended goal is to be able to easily control your printer remotely while being able to check on the printer visually. Now, the idea behind this product is good. However, we'll discuss later on in this video how the implementation just isn't that great. So this kit includes the Corraldi Wi-Fi box along with a webcam. And before starting anything, I wanted to see if any of these devices would work offline. During my tests and attempts at hacking the device, I discovered quite a few important details. First off, the camera is pretty standard, so you can actually use it like a normal webcam, and although the video quality is too bright to begin with, once you adjust the settings, it's actually a decent camera. As for the Wi-Fi box, unfortunately, there were issues starting to creep up. Now, luckily for me, I had two of these on hand, and I was able to sacrifice one in the name of experimental hacking. Now, I'm personally not skilled at this endeavor, however, I did come across some instructions online which seemed to be promising, so I decided to give it a shot. And I promptly bricked the device, and it hasn't really worked since, so that did go as planned. Turning my attention to the backup Wi-Fi box, I began the setup process. The machine doesn't come with a power adapter, so you need to use one that's a 5V to 2A, which most phone adapters use. You won't be able to connect the device without installing the app, which is a little bit disappointing since it means that people like me can't really use it for client work because of security issues. Also, this won't work with anything but your cell phone, which means you'll be forced to use the built-in slicer program to get it to work correctly. Once again, we're going to be a little bit limited on our use case for this. So once you plug in the Wi-Fi box with an internet cable, the lights should look like this when they're fully functional. When you first open the app, you'll be greeted by a welcome screen, which has a browse-only mode and a terms of agreement mode. By selecting the browse-only mode, you will only be able to look at the content and won't be able to access any of the services which are provided by the cloud, which includes the slicing of the 3D models. So if you want to use the device, you're going to need to agree to the terms of service. There are four tabs on the top of the screen which allow you to change between content. The follow tab is where you go to follow your favorite designers and get up-to-date info about their designs. The for you tab is recommendations that will be made to you by Corraldi Cloud. The groups tab is where you can join groups that has content that you want to stay up to date with. The last tab is for models, where you can search for models to print. To be able to slice the downloaded files, you'll first need to create a Corraldi account. You will be prompted to create an account the moment you attempt to download. There's two options for this. One, you can use the phone's phone number, and the other is through email. I chose to use my phone number instead, at which point I received a confirmation number to complete the setup. In order to add a printer, you'll first need to sync up the Wi-Fi box. To do so, you're going to go to the bottom right-hand corner of the screen to the Me button. From here, you're going to select Add Device and choose Scan Code, since this will be the easiest solution. If you haven't already, you will be prompted to give access to your device's camera. From here, you can easily scan the QR code, which will allow you to select from two options. Depending on how your printer is connected to the Wi-Fi box, you'll choose the option accordingly. They do a good job of informing the user what they need to do in order to make sure that the connection is made to the device. At this point, you will be given the password for the Wi-Fi box, which is the default 12345678. This is where you'll be redirected to your network and internet options, where you can enter the password to connect to the device. After entering the password, I could clearly see that I was properly connected to Wi-Fi box, but the box itself wasn't recognizing the internet connection. From this point, I tried pretty much everything I could think of. I rebooted the Wi-Fi box, followed by my network router, and tried resetting them to factory defaults. I then proceeded to troubleshoot my hardware by replacing the network switch and the cables to ensure that it wasn't a faulty connection. My unit, no matter what I tried, would not connect to the internet, which meant that it was pretty much useless. Once you have your devices synced up, it seems that you can add multiple printers to that device. However, I wasn't able to test this feature because the device wasn't working correctly. This brings up a glaring issue with the device. The Wi-Fi box is pretty much useless if it's not connected to the Corraldi Cloud. So was this product even what people were looking for? I'd argue probably not, although I could easily see how someone who was looking from the outside of the community might think so. If this product was intended to rival Octoprint, it needed to provide a very similar and secure service that was stable. Now, to be clear, Octoprint does have its own issues. However, there are ways in which you can actually use it offline. Octoprint also allows the user to slice models with their own software rather than relying on someone else's settings to do the job correctly. This product requires Creality Cloud access and transfers the data to the device via Wi-Fi, which inherently makes the data more unstable when compared to a wired connection. We're also limited to a maximum of 2 devices. A great innovation would have been to allow the user to be able to connect at least 3 to 4 printers and control these remotely. This, however, is not the case either. Frankly, I'm very disappointed with Creality since this is the first product I've used from them that didn't work out of the box. And my final verdict is a 0 out of 10. It couldn't do the basic function and failed to deliver on its promise to its user base. Having a working camera means nothing if the user didn't intend to use the camera on its own. If you spent money on this device, I feel very sorry for you and I really hope that they send you a working device or a refund for what you paid for it. As I said before, I will be posting a link for the product in the description below, but unless you're a talented hacker, this might not be the best solution at the moment. If Creality is able to release a product which functions offline and is resilient enough to compete with Octoprint, then I will revisit the specific view in the future. As I said below, I intend to do a breakdown of what they could do to improve the user experience if they choose to release a new version in the future. Thank you guys for watching, and I hope to see you guys soon. Thank you and take care.
If you liked this video, please feel free to subscribe, and should you wish to support more content like this, you can do so by visiting my online shop, which is in the description below. For those of you who may not know, I do live streams twice a week on Twitch, so make sure to keep an eye out for those if you're interested. Thank you for watching, and I hope to see you guys soon. Thank you and take care.